Okay, let us illustrate this OLS regression in R. So we have our data in a file called vine.csv. We can take a look at it. So this is a typically comma-separated data set. And the first thing we want to do is to load this into a data frame in R. So the variable which shall store the data shall simply be called dat. And there's a command in the base R package, it's called read csv, and it reads such a comma-separated file as we have here. So I just enter the file name, vine csv, and run this code. You can press Control Enter or press on this run button. And then you see that we have now this new variable dat, and it appears here in this global environment in RStudio. And I can also click on it. And then here nicely opens a kind of a table view of this variable where you could sort it, for example. So it's basically sorted now by a vintage. You can sort it in the other direction. And we have the different columns. So price, that will be the average auction price of the vintages from those years. And later in the Artuda problem set, in the second part, you will look in more detail how this price index essentially is computed. So the price is actually relative to the price of this famous vintage from 1961, which has a price index of 100. So here, the vintage of 1952 only had around 36.8% of the price than the vintage of 1961 in these auctions from the year 1990. And we have the three weather variables that are used to in this Wien formula von Aschenfelder, which will be used in the linear regression. Looking at the data set, you also see that for some vintages, the price is missing. So we have an NA that stands for non-available, and that indicates that there's a missing observation. By default, R doesn't use observations which are missing in the regression. So we see this for 1954. That's actually it's missing because there were too few bottles auctioned in the year 1990. So Aschenfelder and Scorsese decided not to compute any price index because it would be too noisy. And also from the years 1981 onwards, we don't have any prices. That's basically, these vintages are so young that they decided that they basically have not really converged to a good auction price, and they could be used later to make out of sample predictions if in some later data set you would collect these prices again, which unfortunately I'm not aware anybody has done so far. So but we will discuss this later in the course. We can also manually omit all missing observations with missing values using the function naOmit. So I call it with that as a function argument and save the return again in that. And you see now the number of observations has dropped to only 27. And if we look at it, basically those years where we had missing values like 1951, they don't appear anymore here. And we also don't have any years after 1980. So let us now run the linear regression. I use the command LM, which stands for linear model. And the first argument here is a formula. And there's kind of a special way how you specify regression formulas in R. So you start with a dependent variable, and that would be here actually, let's start with the price. Later we will use the transformation of the price. We will take the logarithms as quality index, but for the moment assume we measure the quality of a vintage by its average auction price relative to the vintage of 1961, and we regress it on all three variables. Oh, now I've forgotten what the net variables were called. Let's write here call names dot, and I run it. Then I see here in the R console, so everything I run above will be shown here in the R console, all the column names. And so I want to regress it on the temperature. I write temp, then I make a plus sign, plus harvest rain, so the average rainfall during harvest, and the final experimental variable I used so far. Later we will add one more, but so far will be winter rain, the average rainfall during winter. So now I can run this line. Ah, and I get an error. Why do I get an error? Object price not found. Anybody an idea? The problem is that I have not specified the data set that shall be used for the linear regression. So here is a second argument for LM. It's called data. And there I can provide a data frame. And I want to use the data frame dot, because that's the data I have to run the linear regression. And if I now run it, we get now results. We have a coefficient of the intercept, that would be the beta zero hat, a coefficient in front of the temperature, 22.28, that would be the beta one hat, and also for the two other experimental variables, harvest rain and winter rain, we find coefficients. Now, let's see whether you can correctly interpret this coefficient of 22.28 in front of the temperature. Solve the quiz.